Expensive, all that UV paint,
oh, yeah.
Or the UV printing. It's really expensive, and I want to search for something that I can do here, and do only here. So I will start here, and I will end here.
Oh yeah, I see.
Maybe start with painting again, and like here. That's a new painting, but it didn't feel right. So I'm searching, and I don't know yet, but it will come, I think.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Like all the designs I made, it's on the computer, and it's not fully analog. How do you say? It's always with the computer.
Sure, okay.
Yeah. And, every artwork I made, it's always with computer.
Sure.
And I'm searching for a fully analog way
to
make it here and to print it here or whatever. Because all that printing and screen printing, you have to rent in other studio, or you have to pay a lot for those expensive prints, so my artwork costs a lot in production.
Yes.
And yeah. Okay, it's nice in the beginning, but yeah, I'm searching to find something that feels good. And that was actually an idea I had, just put lines on the Mortex and see what will bring. So I will work on it, and if it's ready, we'll see if it's good or not. Maybe print with the white image on it. That would be also nice. Because I like also the analog way of lines. It's always too sharp. It's always too sharp for me, and
oh.
I also always work really sharp. Like if you see here, it's so sharp. It's a digital artwork that I will print analog. But I like this way as well. But it's new for me. It's hard to how you say
to be clean.
To be clean, yeah. I think my work is always too clean. If you make art for someone else, and not for yourself, for who? Yeah, then it's like a product you make,
not the
artwork.
Yeah. So as a designer, I think you're uniquely suited.
Yeah. Maybe it's nice to say that. So I'm designing for clients a lot.
Yeah.
So that feels like I'm designing a product or I design a lot and for clients, and it feels like you're designing a product, but if you make artwork, you have to make it for yourself, and for me it's a design for myself, so I'm my own client, and if I feel it, it's good, or if I see it and I say yeah, it's something in it, I don't know what, because it's abstract art, so you can see whatever you want.
Yeah.
It's also, my artworks are like my own visual language. I also have dyslexia, and yeah, so I can, my language is not good, my Dutch is also not so good, my English,
my English is not so good.
But I like to talk in images, in the visual language.
Yeah, I first know that. Yeah.
Dan moet ik dat eigenlijk altijd direct uitvoeren, omdat ik denk van oké, dat idee zit er nu in mij, ik wil dat uitvoeren en dan is het klaar en dan moet ik er niet meer aan denken of zoiets. Maar van waar dat idee komt, echt geen idee. En ik denk ook, je begint met een idee, dus je begint met iets, een beeld, een image, whatever. En dan maak je dat, en terwijl de bezig bent, komen er nieuwe ideeën, en terwijl dat je dat gemaakt hebt, komt er dan terug iets nieuws en iets nieuws en iets nieuws en iets nieuws, en dat komt like...
Het groeit.
Ja.
Ja, of like an organic organism, an... that feeds itself.
Ja, yeah, voilà.
Ik hoor dat.
Dus ik inspireer mij ook wel, dat is misschien raar om te zeggen, uit mijn eigen werk. Omdat... Ik werk ook zodanig abstract, dat je daar blijft dingen kunt inzien en het gaat ook om techniek, om materiaal, om van alles en nog wat. En als je dan bijvoorbeeld iets maakt, dus je tekent bijvoorbeeld een cirkel in, met een penseel, is dat heel iets anders dan dat je dat bijvoorbeeld zeef drukt of dat je daar een afdruk van neemt of lino sneden of whatever. Maar vanwaar dat er een idee komt, ja.
I love the free.